Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm making a trailer lock that works with an adjustable height coupler. Adjustable height couplers are great for flexibility and perfect for me since I'm not a fan of big drop hitches and heavy loads. For all they're good, they pose one big security problem. In theory, some lowlife could unbolt the thing, install their own coupler, and ride off into the sunset with your trailer. To prevent someone from accidentally borrowing my trailer and the inevitable manhunt that may or may not ensue, I'm adding an additional lock so they at least need to exert some effort to earn their prize. This way they'll likely look for an easier target, or I can politely ask them to leave while they're still tinkering with mine. Think of it as an ounce of prevention, as old Ben used to say. Here I'm using my 1950s era Dewall bandsaw to cut material for the project, and it works like a champ. The blue bits were scrapped, so my only investment was a proper sized trailer ball, locking hitch pin, and of course my time.
The Dewall bandsaw. It's a bad. I love this thing. All right, a little trip to our friendly bandsaw. Got this guy cut off just below flush, which is exactly what I wanted. Otherwise, I would have had this sticking out, and that would have been fine. But I really wanted it below flush because then it's less for somebody to grab onto and try to attempt to take this apart. So I will weld it on the inside, top and bottom. I'll weld it across here all the way around. And then I'll weld it here. And when all of that's finished, then I'll cap this end off and you won't be able to get to it. Finally, there will be a piece coming straight down and that will make up the difference. I'll show you real quick. So this hole here is going to line up in this hole here. So when that's in here, theoretically, it has the ability to tilt, which it really doesn't. But I'm going to put a piece down here anyway, and that'll block that hole. Need to get rid of some paint and start welding. So the paint's cleaned off all the sides. Nothing real exciting there. But the most exciting piece is to get down in here to clean that up, which I just roughed it up a little bit just to get the crap off of it, a little bit of mill scale and whatnot. I use this dude, this little sandpaper on a stick thing, little air-powered sandpaper on a stick. I don't know what you call it. Anyway, some people use these for spot welds. I think that's kind of silly. I use this for things I can't get to very well, and the belts do not last on these things at all, but it's super handy for a place like this where this tool will just get in there real easy and it's just done, you know, 30 seconds or so and you're done. This gets you a better idea what's going on. So this pin is actually going to be a hitch pin that will lock in place. This lock will still be here, and then there's going to be a piece that comes down and it'll block this hole right here, or this pair of holes. So this guy is going to be welded in solid. I'll weld it inside and on the bottom and all the way around. So you'll have this lock and the lock that'll be on the bottom here, and then this hole will be blocked. Not my best welding, but not my worst. So it's not going to fall off. And now I'll make that leg, and this will be pretty much done except for some paint. Not bad for some scrap material. Now I just need to close off the open ends and throw down on some paint.
Here's a view of the mostly finished product installed on the trailer. Paint will have to wait for warmer weather. My shop isn't heated and ambient temperatures aren't cooperating. I won't even try the basement. I accidentally discovered long ago that painting and working on fiberglass in the basement is a bad idea unless you want to wake up chasing white rabbits or not wake up at all. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next project.